In the summer of 1949, the American president, Harry S. Truman, arrived at the shipyards in Groton, Connecticut, to dedicate the world's first nuclear-powered submarine. It was the start of a revolution in travel at sea. To get this far had taken years of research and development, and although it was President Truman's signature on the hull, it was left to Mrs. Mamie Eisenhower, the wife of his successor, to perform the actual launching. By then, it was 1954. By the standards of the day, the Nautilus, as she was called, was enormous, more than 300 feet long. She could travel several times round the world underwater without refueling. Armed with underwater ballistic missiles, the nuclear submarine was to become the world's most formidable weapon. The Soviet Union soon followed Nautilus with atomic submarines of her own, and the boats, with their huge firepower and almost unlimited range of travel underwater, became the foundation of the Cold War's nuclear deterrence. Deterrence apart, the most practical role the nuclear submarines were to play was in surveillance. They could glide undetected into enemy waters, and with their sophisticated electronic equipment, or even the good old-fashioned expedient of looking through the periscope, the crew could spy on shore installations, other warships, suspicious cargo boats, and all the other espionage targets the Cold War required. On board Nautilus, on the 8,000-mile maiden voyage, what really caught the public's imagination was the 2,000-mile journey made under the Arctic ice cap. She submerged near Port Barrow, then travelled beneath the North Pole itself, re-emerging at Spitsbergen, north of Norway. From there, she sailed to the United Kingdom for a very special welcome. British scientists had made a substantial contribution to the building of the boat, particularly the nuclear physicist. At the end of her voyage, Nautilus was awarded a presidential citation. The American ambassador, J.H. Whitney, explained why.
In completing the first voyage in history across the top of the world by cruising under the Arctic ice cap from the Bering Strait to the Greenland Sea.
So began a new chapter in the Cold War and a new era in ocean travel.